I'm a YouTuber. I have to film everything. Another video, another stupid idea. The Raptor has all fell off. I didn't prime it, so that's on me. But we're going to Devon in 3 weeks' time, the first week of June. I've decided I want to take the truck rather than the van, so I'm going to attempt to build a camper van back for this. I'll take you along for the ride. Wish me luck. I've gone and got the steel. I'm now going to go home. It is a weekend, by the way. I'm now going to go home and pull out an old caravan I've got to try and use the sides of the caravan on the truck. So I'll film all that, because no doubt that's going to go wrong. But first, I just have to show you Chris's van, because he's got standard wheels on the back and it looks absolutely horrific. What are those? Where are they? They're gone. That's terrible. Let's take on the truck to see if it'll still do truck things. Probably not. Some tow bar issues. Lovely summer's evening. I'm armed with a caravan, a screwdriver. Gonna attempt to take it apart. I don't really know how these come apart, but I want to use these side panels on the side of the camper. This is an old family caravan that's been around since I was pretty young. But I don't know if any of you have ever tried to get rid of a caravan, they make it nearly impossible. So it's just hung around on the bit of land. So I'm gonna attempt to recycle it. Use this middle panel is, funnily enough, the right height. So from this trim up to this one is the right height for what we need. I can get this side solid up to here. We'll do what we need. The other side, however, has got many windows and doors. So I'll try and cut it in such a way that I can use, this is hard when it's backwards. I'll try and use the top half of this as the door to get in and try and get that somewhere in the middle of the back of the truck. Maybe lose the windows, maybe keep that one, maybe end up with many windows. I'm not really sure. I'm just playing this by ear, but we've got 2 weeks now until we're going to Devon, so I'm not sure if I'm going to do one long video or whether this will be in a two-parter, but it's going to be suspenseful either way. But I'm going to attempt to take this apart. I'll check back in a minute. I will just say I'm not any sort of caravan expert, so I'm just making this up as I go, but I'm reckoning I undo these screws and that comes off, same along there. And the side will just gracefully come off. Ah, I don't see it, but fuck it. Might as well get you ruining the hard work. I called in the reinforcements. So you've just seen a solid day of me messing around with a caravan for no reason, because the sides don't come off a caravan as I thought they would. So that was pointless, but we have a backup plan. Rob has got me some PVC sheets for free. So if you see me driving up the M25 in a refrigerated truck, no you didn't. But we're gonna get it done. I'm now gonna put a floor in, build some walls, bit over the cab, put the stuff on it, and as simple as that, I'm gonna have a camper van, but we'll see. To make myself feel better about the amount of work I've got to do, I'm just gonna hand you to Chris for a minute so he can explain what he has to do.
Everything.
Yeah, that's not even an exaggeration.
I've got a long list of small jobs, which takes for a lot of time.
Where's the hat?
You just look like a broken man when you're walking.
I just want the hat.
If you'd like a nice hammer, Chris, if you just pop onto the Dropworks Customs website.
Pop onto the Dropworks website and pick yourself up a nice Dropworks hammer.
Yep, the man said it.
Right now, it's an emergency, so I may have to swing like fuck.
Stay hydrated. Now. Every time I got to film you started hammering, so I thought I might as well just film you. No, we're not coming. For those asking how the Raptor's gone, great. If anyone was wondering if you should prime it first, yes you should. We ran out of time, but the bed looks nice. I'm happy with it. You're not completely happy. Obviously, if it was still Raptor, it would be nicer. But I'm gonna have to peel it all off and go again. But you learn these things, don't you?
You'll never do it. Once that caravan back goes on, you'll never take it off. You'll be like, I'm a camper now.
In reality, I'm building this whole camper van back just to cover the Raptor. But I started on a frame, so this will be the floor. I'll have a little drop down inside at the front so I can put the leisure battery and things under the floor. And then this back end means I can drop the tailgate and keep spare wheel jacks, whatever, underneath it. So I'm actually losing the space in that sense. But what I'll now do is lift this frame off, weld it, because I don't want to burn the paint off the truck more than I probably just have. And then I'm going to start putting the uprights on, and it's going to go up and above the cab. Basically just aiming to make the stupidest thing I can on the back of this truck. So we'll see how it goes. This is just getting stupid. Oh, yes. Just finished welding up the front half of the frame. It's ridiculous. It really is. But you can start to see the idea here. This is a wardrobe at the front. And the bed will be down there. I don't know what else you put in a camper van. But I've just got to do the back end now. Got to work out where the door's going to go, and I've got these rounded corners. So I might round the PVC, I'm not sure. But it's getting there, we're getting somewhere. It's definitely a camper van. Here's your parcel for Chris.
Huh?
It's for
Lardan.
Fucking Lardan Transporters.
Lardan, mate.
Lardan Transporters, mate.
Oh, look at that, that's fucking saucy, isn't it? Ah, that's some nice interior plastic.
That's not, that's a big waste of money. You could have painted some ply.
That's beautiful. That's nice, that's legit.
It's not. It's expensive plastic. What's this for, Chris?
This is for my interior panels for split screen. Because it was a panel van, it was a commercial vehicle, so it had like plastic door cards and stuff in basically that.
but obviously it wouldn't have had any interior panels in the back, but I'm going to put interior panels in the back with some insulation, so I've got to make all the panels. So I bought big sheets of ABS, grey embossed plastic. Nice.
But what am I up to? So I've flown apart and done this one, or depending on how this video is edited, you've just seen me do the other one, or you may see me, I may be talking and then in a minute you'll see me do that one. So that one's obviously just all tacked in so far all the way around. I've cut the panel for that one, so I'm going to get that all tacked in. And then I'll get then the top of that one tacked in, and then spend about an hour welding. And go from there.
It's all coming together quite nicely. I'm more interested in Jack's Ranger though.
Look at it. It's got to be a big rolling camper that. Look how happy he is. Zoom.
Apologies for the lack of updates, but I haven't got my tripod, so I haven't been doing any time lapses or anything. Yeah. I'll put the video in here of when it was outside on the truck, but it's now back off the truck, and I'll just do a little walk around and show you where we're at. This might be one of the funniest things I've ever done. Here's where we're at. I've built a burger van. These are all PVC sheets that I got for free. I think they'll work quite nicely. I've sealed them all, stuck them on, and then pop riveted them on. There's obviously an angle trim gonna go around all of the edges. The frame, it's pretty much there now. I've got to make a rear door, which I'll film. But basically, I've now got to trim the sheets down to fit this front section and up under there. Two roofing sheets I've got over there. They're long 10-foot ones. And there's some trims somewhere to run down the middle of them. Then that'll be pretty much sealed. Then it's down to putting windows in, floors, interior. I'm hoping the whole thing's gonna be sub £500. It's still light as well. I mean, I can still pick it up. So, should be a sub £500 camper van that looks incredible.
Available soon for a sub total of £9,000. Book now.
Yeah, the way I'm looking at it is if I'm £500 complete, that leaves me an extra £60,000 spare from a T6. So I guess I'll just go and buy a Porsche or something with my spare money.
Save it.
Yeah, I'm saving money, you know, left, right and centre.
We don't need no T6s.
We do, it's our whole business. Yeah, I am now a camper. I now identify as a he, her, camper, man.
One life, live it.
Yeah. Adventure before dementia. We're all up inside that van.
That was this van.
You've dropped your horn.
Man deserves a better life than me.
In other news,
I'm going to put a subframe in the truck, the first time since the bed's been done. Then I don't even have to strap it in. All that Raptor will hold it in place. Yeah, if it falls out, I'm keeping going. I ain't stopping. I ain't stopping. Sounds so Norfolk.
Welcome back. You've joined me bagging another 2.5.
Wow.
2.6, actually.
What a change.
Yeah, got to do what you got to
do. Right. Hold this. I'm going to try something. I need a cameraman.
Hey, I'm a cameraman, dude.
Follow me.
I am cameraman.
That's not how they walk, is it?
Sometimes, yeah.
Well, like the bush, right?
It's usually a bit more attitude. You're not usually this happy, but you're working on your own stuff, so.
It is a late evening. It's not early. What I'm attempting here is to make an opening rear that doesn't leak. I'll start off by doing. I've chamfered these to all the right angles that they fit. Dead in here. Come on. Oh no.
Ah, yes.
So they fit snug in. Oh, I'm only a little bit more off that one. Come. No. So they'll fit dead in there. So what I'll do now is I'll tack weld both of these in tight. I'll then cut the centres and make sure everything stays tight. Now, my plan here, a hinge at the top. Obviously, there's no way to then seal. So if I run a hinge about here, when that opens, that will go back in on itself.
Oh, smart.
Yes. And when that closes, but this outer face will lap over the top of that, meaning water can't go uphill. So it will be,
Very good, very nice, I like it.
This back sheet will come to this corner.
Okay.
So I'll run a flat seal down top. So that will then seal. So I'm up with that.
It all makes sense as it starts to come together, I'm sure.
Yeah, I've not been filming enough, so. It's gonna go from, I'm gonna make a caravan.
Here's a caravan.
It's very short for time. I'm just short in general, but.
Yeah, I'm like above it. I'm filming up here. You're in the bottom of the shot.
That's
fine. Yes. Caravan!
Burger van at the minute. It's gonna be a caravan, maybe. If it all goes tits up, I'm gonna start selling burgers out of it. Yeah. Gonna put a big caravan window in the back. So it'll look caravan.
So that will be your door slash rear window. I like it.
Yeah, and in theory I'll just let's go camping. It's quite big.
It's large, isn't it?
It's deceiving, but it is actually quite big.
I'm excited for the TARDIS.
it's the same size inside as a short wheelbase 2.5. Plus, I actually have the world's biggest wardrobe here.
Look at this. This is that should be enough, be big enough to house Fryer's clothes for the week.
It's not gonna be. Last clip, I said I'd do a walk around momentarily. Sorry, it's about a fortnight later. Now I'll do the walk around this time. So I got all the sheets on, roofing sheets, front, obviously. I'm underneath this There was a little bit of mastic left on there. It was the only bit I didn't wipe down, and then all of the dust and road grime and everything has stuck to it. So it does come off. I just haven't cleaned it up yet. I got this aluminium trim, ran it around all the edges. I wasn't really sure how to finish it. I didn't want to miter everything and have a weird point, so I just cut them all slightly different. But windows, the only thing we salvaged out of the caravans that I spent, you know, a day messing about with. So there's a small one that side, and then a bigger one this side. Now this one's currently screwed shut because the window was actually bowed where it had sat in the caravan, so it didn't really go on the sill that well, and I didn't want it to blow off on the motorway. But side profile's pretty nice, although I think you've seen that in other bits of the video anyway. But let's have a look inside. I put one of these locks on because I couldn't be bothered to have another set of keys to lose. So I fitted one of these and it's actually worked quite well. I haven't had a chance to put anything on yet to hold the door open. So I spent the whole holiday using this stick. The stick has been from Norfolk to Cornwall, Devon, New Forest. Now it's back in Norfolk, but that done me well. Got the wood in, fitted lights. What I've done is ran Kingspan in the gaps, and then some, I think it's 3.6 the ply. The floor is then thick ply. Carpet was left over from a house. This is an Ivano mattress, so it does fold up. So when you're in there, you can fold that up into a seat at the other end. Gives you a little bit more floor space. The lights are currently actually just battery powered ones because I bought a leisure battery. All the lights are wired into that switch box, chargers, everything's wired into that, but I never wired the leisure battery in. I ran out of time and then just had it in the front seat of the truck the whole holiday, because luckily we were on hookup. And there's a hole in the floor there with a frame. This bit of wood goes on to obviously finish the floor, but what that enables me to do is to then get through the bottom when it's on the truck to bolt it onto the bed. And also I ran the hookup and everything through that. The cupboard is finished, but I haven't boarded out inside it. And also, I don't know whether to run doors or just a little curtain potentially on it, but it's gonna get some use throughout the rest of the year. I'm just gonna try and get out camping more. I've also, for no apparent reason, bought an Ivor Williams top for the back of the truck. So that bolts on. It's off a Hilux, so I'm gonna have to extend it ever so slightly, but it should be pretty cool. I've got a cool idea for extending it that's gonna be a little bit different. We've got the Volvo in for full air ride, so we're gonna build the struts and bits for that. The auto finesse bay, I've been making this roof rack for. So the idea is this will hold a 270 awning on the other side. So I've obviously had to make it fairly bulky to hold the weight, but being a high top, we didn't want it to sit too high. So I've actually sunk the rack onto the roof. So all these legs obviously sit level. So half of the legs and half aren't, but it's actually sunk halfway inside it, which I thought was a pretty cool touch. But I'll do something on that when it is complete, because at the minute it's sort of halfway there. And that is about it at the minute. We've just got to get through some of these things. The T25 is now gone. I don't know if I'm meant to say or not, but that's now going to a competition company. So we're going to do a few extra bits on that. I'm going to paint the top half and the roof to tidy them up. New seals, new door rubbers, all that sort of stuff. So it is as clean as it can be. And Miles has asked if I'll take that to Bug Jam. So I will do a video on that. Probably be the next video. I'll do that on that sort of the lead up to Bug Jam, and then taking it to Bug Jam. Other than that, there's not a massive amount going on. Got plenty to get on with, but one thing at a time. I'll do a couple more videos on the truck, anything I do on there. I'll do one on the 25 or T3, whatever you want to call it. And then after that, it's going to be, I want to build the Beetle ready for summer. I know we're in summer, but I want to build just something fun to potter around in. That's
about 10 years we've had that and not done it. It's a bus outside. And we've also got to do Freya's Navara. So I'll do a whole series on that because nothing's been done on that as such so far. We've only done little bits. So I'll do a whole series on that. So it might be Beetle first, might be Navara. But we will see. Like and subscribe. I think I've got to get one more subscriber before 1,000. So from someone who was too scared to film themselves to 1,000, I'm happy. But sorry, I keep forgetting to film. I'll get better, maybe. Also, for those who keep asking about the Land Rover, that is going to be done and there is going to carry on the series. But that's done during work of time. That is a customer's car. A lot of these videos, it's just things I do weekends and evenings. But the Land Rover is actually a customer's one. So that will be coming straight after the T25. So I guess Bug Jam is July. So straight after Bug Jam, back on the Land Rover. This time I'll actually say bye and you probably won't see me again until the next video, potentially. Also, I'm actually joking. This is the end.